Hey guys, it's JB here, and this is my first ever video of a game I am really looking forward to. And this is Star Wars Battlefront on PC. This is the beta that was actually released last week. I had the chance to play it, and that's me getting killed by Darth Vader. That is some of the crazy shit that happens in this game. I can only say to you that this is one of the best demos I've ever played. This is just a couple of videos. I've got about three or four different videos of me playing, and I've had the chance to upload them for you to give you all an idea of what the game looks like, but also to give you guys an idea of, you know, me playing PC games, because I know that you don't see me play PC games. You see me play WWE Supercard or 2K15 or whichever games they are. But my roots are playing as a Counter-Strike 1.6 player, and also from the original Counter-Strike games, 1.0, 1.3, CS Source. You've got all the other normal games, Battlefront, the original Star Wars games, as well as Battlefield, and also games like Command & Conquer and whatnot. So I'm originally a PC player, but this is my first foray into PC game videos. I hope you guys enjoy it. So this is just me introducing myself. And basically, this is me playing Star Wars Battlefront on the Hoth map, which is basically a defense and attack map. As you see at the moment, I'm actually in the defensive mode. And that's just me destroying an AT-ST there, or what's called a chicken walker. If you want to know some stuff about the Star Wars lore, always check on the internet, go on Google and have a look at some of the names of the things. If you haven't ever watched Star Wars before, I'd definitely recommend you watch it, because this game is definitely one of the most exciting games coming up. But this, it is bonkers. Everything you see in front of you is happening real time. There's no pre-scripted stuff. There's some stuff in the background, but that's about it. Throwing a grenade over there and killing the guy that was standing by the satellites. Now, the idea of this is you can see the little activate section, which is just right in front of you there. The activate section, you have to go over to that and activate that. And that then brings in a bomber who attacks two big walking like camel kind of things. They can use vehicles like the one I'm actually getting now, which I've just spliced into the video, which is an A-wing, and this basically allows me to go after all the other flying objects that are in the air, and also kind of get an aerial advantage, take out the walkers, which you'll see here, which is just coming up in a second, just down the floor. Those are the things you want to stop. Those things are walking along. The reason you want to stop those is because that thing in the distance is your shield. If they get to that and destroy that, you are screwed and the game is over. So this gives you definitely an advantage, plus it also gives you the ability of using special updates and weapons, such as the missiles you can see in the bottom right hand corner right now. Now, in the early videos, this is like literally the very, very early of the beta, I wasn't very good at flying. You'll see in my later videos later on, I'm much better here. I do try something very cheeky here and it doesn't come off. I reversed and braked and actually got someone as they were speeding up into the back of me. On this part here, I'm actually going to just run outside and go back into the combat. But let me know if there's any specific games that you'd like to play. That guy just randomly appeared out of nowhere. There has been some couple of issues with the spawn points in Battlefront, especially the fact that I just sometimes randomly you end up appearing from nowhere. And that random TIE fighter just going into the building. There's a section here I'm just getting my ass kicked and I end up throwing out a grenade just purely by luck, see if I can grab someone, and I end up running away because I think I'm gonna get killed and actually end up surviving in the end, which is obviously awesome. So let me know if there's any other PC games you prefer I play. Battlefront is just the start of my foray into different games, because YouTube is all not just about Supercard and WWE games as well, there's other games as well. I'd make a stupid decision of keeping my head up here. Always use the cover, otherwise you get your head taken off by a giant laser. And here I'm actually setting up a shield. Now this shield stops anything but heavy fire coming through. This is probably my biggest fail, in terms of the fact that I didn't know how to melee, so I just threw a grenade on the guy and ended up killing, which is obviously great because it's helped me get to the control point, which you can see here, the uplink is being activated. You have to get both of those, as many of those as are activated as possible. It gives you a additional rocket or an additional spaceship that goes after the camel-like things, which is called AT-ATs or AT-ATs. Now, when it gets to a certain point, the shield to go down for that AT-AT, and those things will attack it. And then you can attack it as well, which is obviously the idea of the game, so you can win. What's going to happen here is we are going to go after the second one, see if we can get in there. I think we're going to be able to get this one. Yeah, the guy does manage to get it. Luckily, he missed that grenade, which is incredible. Me randomly shooting a TIE interceptor there, which is one of the Imperials or the other sides. Now, we're doing incredibly well because you can see in the top left-hand corner, top middle left-hand corner, we have 7 of those Y-Wings, and we're doing some incredible amounts of damage to this walker that's in the background. What I've done here is I've set up a little shield bubble, and I'm actually protecting myself from the walker and anything else around it, and also shooting at the walker itself. And as you can see here, a couple of extra bits of ammo into it, and the AT-AT is destroyed, and we win. Now onto the other side, because you pay 2 sides for every map that you do. And you can see here, I'm now playing for the Imperials. I'm an Imperial Stormtrooper. Trust me, a lot more smarter than the Stormtroopers that are in the films. And there you're going to see me killing a couple of additional people to keep the uplinks on our side and stop them getting the jets, the Y-Wings, to basically attack the AT-ATs. Set up my own little personal shield bubble there, and I end up almost screwing myself over with this little turret. Now, this little turret is, so it's quite useful in the game, but it does make you quite exposed, and there are some stationary turrets around the map. Now, I know that a lot of you may potentially already have seen videos like this, and everything I'm explaining to you, you probably are thinking, well, I already know this already, why is he telling me it? It's because not a lot of people have actually seen this game live, and I am so uber passionate about it. I just thought I'd at least give you guys the opportunity to understand how it works. This section of the video is a bit more gameplay related, because as you're going to see in a second, I do get a couple of really, really, really awesome kills coming up, and this is more about the gameplay side of things and being strategic in your positioning, etc. That AT-ST got blown up there, which I'm hoping the guy got out. I think the guy got out. And I'm up on the hill here, taking a bit of a strategic advantage, and I end up getting out my sniper rifle, which is basically a one-shot. Hopefully one shot kill, and bang, straight in the head. Guy in the background going along the side there, tried to take him out as well. Not so successful in that part. But then, oddly, their entire team spawns in front of me. How crazy is that? So basically, I'm kind of thinking, well, what to do here? I managed to get a little bit of a lucky kill there. And decided to use the jetpack, which is on the bottom right-hand side. To fly over and kill the guy here and still keep going and taking out more and more people. If you've ever got your own personal favorite third person shoot or first person shoot, because this can flip, I prefer to use first person just for my background, but apparently there are advantages to using third person as well, just be able to see more of the map, etc. Catching that, disabling that uplink again up on the vantage point at the top, taking out that guy there with a headshot with the recycler rifle again, and going to move on to the next point. And let me know what you played, if you've played Battlefront, if you like it yourself. Going to move along to the next one here. I managed to kill a guy at the top of this table mountain, effectively. I'm going to then take out a few additional people here, end up taking out the rocket and just going, oh, screw it, I'll just kill him. And then coming face to face with a laser, which is from that guy in the background. Bit of a distance on that one. This is the flying side of the Imperials. Now, the Imperials have TIE fighters. So, TIE fighters are basically lots of different types. I end up taking out a couple of people in a second, we'll see. But again, my flying skills at this point, this is all in the same game from the last side you had. I'm not that great, but I managed to kill a top player, which is a player at the top of the other team, which would be the Rebel Alliance. And I come too close to the mountain and kill myself. You're going to see a theme there. I'm not the greatest at flying around at this. I find myself another TIE fighter over here. But you can also get yourself little hero activations as well. Hero activations help with the fact that they're me just flying into an X-Wing there. That's awesome. Now here's me saying, oh, fuck it again. As you can see in the background, the guy is randomly there. I take out the rocket, decide to screw aim and just take out with explosives. I'm going to make my way into the room there. But whilst we've got this little bit of time to discuss, because it's so hectic, so much stuff on the screen at once, let me know if there's any particular first-person shooters, PC games that you want to play. We're trying to set up for pretty much the whole video, but it's so much action going on, so much awesomeness going on, that it's definitely worth paying attention to what's on the screen here. Effectively, I'm commentating on my own video, which is the first time I've actually ever done this. I managed to kill this guy here, and then oddly decide to ignore the grenade that's in front of me, and I get popped up by Grimmy Vine, the guy who just literally rammed into me with a X-Wing. I'm going to take out this guy here in a second. You see, complete luck, no aim at all, and end up almost getting killed by the guy behind. I boost out of the way, try to get out of the situation. And that ends up getting me one of these thermal detonators. Now this causes a lot of damage if it goes in the right area. As you can see, that guy ended up on the end of a roasting from a grenade. You'll hear a little noise in the background in a second, and I mentioned about heroes, hero add-ons. Now the hero tokens you can get allow you to access two heroes on this level, which is either Luke Skywalker, which is on the Jedi, so the Rebel Alliance side, or the hero side. And then you've also got Darth Vader, and there's Luke Skywalker from the distance, and he's going to chime over and basically try and kill all of us, because he's super, super powered and has access to really, really long range attacks. He realizes he's not going to win against an AT-AT or the big camel thing if you don't listen to Star Wars. I got a little bit of damage on Luke Skywalker over there, and he ends up somehow evading a lot of the fire that's over here. He kills a couple of people, and I end up just popping over and killing him, which... that's the first time I've actually had done any damage that haven't killed anyone that is a hero. Again, screw the aim, just fire a rocket, get the kill, and that's going to end up meaning that I get over to this point. I completely miss that guy, go for the power up, turn around, and bang, I'm dead. So he was obviously a little bit smarter than I was. This next point is going to be a TIE Interceptor. A TIE Interceptor is another version of the TIE Fighter that was basically in... For the Rebel side would have been the A-Wing, or very similar to the TIE Fighter, which you can see in front of me, which I flew earlier on. But basically at this point, there's no way that they can win, because they'd have to do so much firepower, so we are going to get the victory. Not great flying skills, as you can see here, and I end up completely screwing myself over and flying into a turret. That's going to be it for the first ever Battlefront video. Let me know if you liked what you saw. This is all about explaining to you the game, so you can enjoy the rest of the videos coming up. Please send a like if we can get even as 50 likes, that'd be amazing. And if you can just also give your comments on what you think and what your favourite PC games are below. And most importantly, guys, Zoliv!